International Airport. We're at the bottom of a 250-metre grass strip, which slopes from where we are up to the top there at about a 1 in 10 slope. It's about 88 feet higher at the top than it is at the bottom. We're going to taxi up to around about three-quarters of the way up the strip before we turn to do our final run-ups, set our flaps and head off for takeoff. That'll give us about 180 metres of runway, which is way more than we're going to need to take off in the A22 Foxbat. About 50 feet above the runway, you've got the opportunity to whack the power on and head off to the right hand. left-hand side. So once you're down about 10 feet, you really are committed. Anyway, you'll see. We've now turned final, approaching runway 09 at Windrush International. We're at 700 feet, which is about 500 feet above the start of the runway. And we've reduced our speed to a little under 60 knots to allow us to put on full flap. And what we're going to do is to approach the strip as low as we reasonably can while being under power. And as we land at the strip, we'll want to keep the power on. And usually we don't wash off all of our speed as we land, but we want to be able to keep the power on so that we are not just flaring, but also really climbing a little as we come into land. As we go over the vineyard, you'll see that I'm aiming to the left of the runway. I like to come in over what is essentially the taxiway, because then if anything drops me as I get to the beginning of the runway proper, which is really parallel with that that bank you can see clay coloured to the right of our approach point. I land on the taxiway, and the worst that happens to me is a fairly bumpy landing, rather than smacking straight into what is a clay wall. But once we're over the actual runway approach, I'll allow the plane to drift a little to the right. So a little bit rougher than I would have liked, but we're down in one piece, and we've got masses of runway to play with as we have to push on the power in order to be able to climb back up to take off position. So we'll turn around, set the flaps to a single stage of flaps, and give it another go and see if we can do better next time. So this time we're going to climb just up to 700 feet, turn straight around, and head back in and see how we go.
506.6.